How do you feel just things are, mindset you guys heading into this game tonight? Obviously, fans are treating it like it's a big one. How do you guys
feel? I feel good. I mean, I think especially obviously with what's on the line and us being able to get the tiebreaker if we're able to win this game, it's definitely big for us. And we came in, we cleaned stuff up. We had 2 days between the game, and we just have to be ready for tonight.
It's not a game seven, but do you treat it as a must win at all?
Obviously, yeah. I mean, obviously it's not, but you know, you can. I think we're eighth. You can win the game, and I don't know if Phoenix plays tonight or not, but. If they don't play tonight, which, I don't know, we go straight to six because we'll jump. We would jump both of them. We'd be tied with Dallas, but we'd have the tiebreaker. Big things can definitely happen, but we just have to go out and we have to worry about ourselves, fix what we can fix, control what we can control, and, we have a chance to come out with a win.
Can you think of games this season where you feel like you've bounced back well or even thought that this would be an important game for you guys, bearing where the schedule's at?
Even like when we lost in D.C. and then, you know, you play a good Orlando team who hadn't really lost at home, and we go in and we win that game. That's one I can think of off the top of my head. But this is definitely a big game for us tonight. Obviously, with only 10 games left, trying to get out of that play-in spot.
Watching back the film from last game, what stood out is what kind of needs to be cleaned up?
I think defensively we gave up. They shot 39 threes, which is around their average, but making 22, we have to be better. We didn't give up as many corner threes as they do shoot. I think they're number one team in corner shooting threes, and I think we gave up 8 or 9, but we know we have to be able to limit Kyrie and Luka. They shot more above the break threes than they average, and they made more than they average. So we have to be, we can't just let it be, you know, they made shots. We have to be able to make guys miss and be able to get out and run.
You had 5 games in 7 nights. Were you guys a little fatigued after Tuesday, do you think? And was a good day off yesterday, 2 days ago?
Yeah, I mean, 5 and 7, four different cities. I mean, those things happen in the NBA. Obviously, they were on a back-to-back as well. But we have to be better. Offensively, we weren't good. Defensively, we weren't good. As far as the second half is concerned. So we have to be able to clean up those things. We can't worry about fatigue. Everybody's tired in game 73 in the NBA.
Does it feel like that all these games are just, in a sense, playoff games? You guys are almost like a playoff game every night?
Yeah, I mean, a lot of the teams that we're playing at this point in the season are fighting for positioning. So obviously, you know, every game is important throughout the season. But right now with us playing Dallas, and then we play the Clippers, and we play New Orleans, we play Phoenix again. All these teams are fighting for positioning, so all these games definitely will feel like playoff games.
Would you rather have that, or would you rather have, okay, we're in a great position and we're cushy and we're doing whatever?
I mean, definitely you'd rather be in a spot like that where you can go out and try different coverages and things like that, but at the end of the day, that's not the position that we're in. We're in this position because we put ourselves in this position, and we have to try to fight our way out.
How do you feel like a guy, you know, someone like Keon, who's experiencing a lot of this for the first time, especially these high-pressure games, how do you feel like, especially a matchup when you've got like Kyrie and Luka in these pressure situations, like how well do you think it benefits somebody like him?
It's definitely big, especially because this is really his first time being in a rotation in the NBA. You're kind of seeing what it's like, how different the game is from game 40 to game 70, especially with teams trying to prepare themselves for playoff runs. And you see the intensity of games. I think it definitely builds you as a player. It helps you. But for us, obviously, we want to win those games while also learning how to deal with that type of pressure.
With last year being your first postseason, what do you feel like you learned that you make sure you want to have rolling right now as you get to that point?
I mean, just how important it is to be able to be clicking on all cylinders, both offensively and defensively. Because last year, you know, we were such a high-powered offensive team, and then in the playoffs we were better defensively, but I feel like it affected our offense. So now we have to be better. We have to be able to do both at a high level, because if you can't, you know, it's going to be hard to win in the postseason.
Does the whistle they're letting teams get away with right now, or the lack of, feel like postseason, let you prepare for that a little bit?
Definitely. I think they've obviously let a lot of things go, so you have to be able to play for that type of physicality.
Speaking of Keon, did he let everyone know about Alabama today?
No. I didn't see that they beat UNC, right?
Yeah,
I saw that, but nah.
So HB wasn't more quiet than usual?
Nah, HB don't talk too much anyway, so nah.
Appreciate it. Thank you, sir.
Quick one for you. How are you going about balancing knowing, like, okay, these last 10 games are obviously really important while also being able to stay in the moment?
I mean, you have to be able to take it one game at a time. That's what we're doing. obviously we all know what the standings are, but I mean, you can't look ahead or look past anybody right now because we're all basically fighting for the same thing. Thanks.